Yeah, good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, who is that just spoke to me? Please enable Anush, your video.
Anush, sir.
Anush, show me your face.
Sir.
Speak. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Okay. Norbo. Norbo. Yes, today I want you to be as a class monitor, okay? Because last class I didn't see your face at all. In the beginning you came and you just went. I thought you slept.
No, sir.
Huh? Today I'll be monitoring you. Don't disable your video.
Okay, sir.
Clear?
Okay, sir.
Anush and Norbo, two are there. The other, who is this? Please introduce yourself, others.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
I'm Lipika, sir.
Lipika, Lipika, okay. Yeah, one more is there. Who is that? Introduce yourself to get used to. Okay, who is this? Please speak once so that I'll be in a position to understand all are there. The specs girl, sorry I am using this kind of words because, yeah. Talk, what's your name? So still a few are left, they have to come. Not you, one more girl is there, who is that? Where is Prabhanjan? Prabhanjan didn't enter till now. Norbu, no way you will disable your video.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, Prabhanjan, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah. Okay, sir, I will start the class now. Be attentive. Don't disable your video, first of all. Those who enter newly, then they please introduce yourself so that I'll be in a position to understand whether you joined the class or not. Now, right now we have six participants, I mean six students, okay? Everybody can hear me, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Norbu, can you hear me? Norbu, can you hear me? Okay, now I'll share my PPT. Yeah, before that, last class we discussed about the algorithm and the steps to follow the algorithm, correct? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes, sir. So today's topic is flowchart. Let us learn the difference between flowchart and algorithm. Before that, we have to understand the advantage and disadvantage of algorithm. We'll finish that and then we'll move over to flowchart. So advantage, there are so many advantages of algorithm. The first advantage is, it is a step-by-step representation of a solution to a given problem. Means what? We have a problem. We have a problem, and that problem is being divided into step wise to represent the solution, and it is easy to understand as we did in the previous class. Okay, as we did in the previous class, we had discussed about so many programs. See, this question was a simple question, but we elaborated the question step wise and understood the question properly, and we got the output of that. The same way, the next is, it has got definite procedure which can be executed within a set of period. See, it is having a definite procedure, means what? The procedure is clear. You should start with start. Rajbhanjan, from where, what you have to do?
Start and stop, sir, last.
Yeah, beginning is start and ending is stop. After start, what you are going to do the first thing?
The inputs.
Yeah, very good. Input and the ending part will be the output. That is for?
Output.
Yeah, that is for algorithm, okay? It is dependent of programming language. See, now when you're writing the steps, you have to use certain languages, means proper words, proper language words, okay? Those kind of words you need to use. It is easy to debug as every step has got its own language sequence. Means what? Debugging. Do you know what is bugging and debugging?
No,
come on, tell me, what is bugging, what is debugging?
Bugging, some errors.
Yeah, who said this? Norbu?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, bugging in the sense you are encountered to an error. Okay, you have encountered an error, but debugging, you are coming out of the error, means solving the error. That is debugging. Okay, now where advantages are there, there will be disadvantages. Where good people are there, bad people will be there. Where evil is there, God is there. Means in this world, in this society, we can find every kinds of students. Okay, we can find every types of students. We can find every kinds of people. Okay, so there is an advantage. So when you have an advantage, you will have disadvantage also. What is this disadvantage? The first disadvantage will be time consuming. See, you have a question. You have a question and you're breaking down the question into steps. Step-wise, you're breaking down the question. When you're breaking down the question, obviously, it takes more time. It consumes more time. So what happens when it consumes more time? Okay, an algorithm is developed first, which is converted in flowchart and then computing program. See here, algorithm was developed, which is converted into flowchart. Now you have a question and you have stepwise thinking. Stepwise, you're breaking the question. Once you break down the question, you show that in a geographical way or graphical representation. Okay, that is one thing. So flowchart gives you more clarity than algorithm. Keep it in mind, students. Flowchart will give you more clarity than algorithm. But the difference is, algorithm will solve, or algorithm will break the questions one by one, stepwise. Flowchart, by the symbols, we create the flowchart of the problem and we get the output of that. But in the algorithm, we don't create any symbols, we use steps. Got it? Let us go to flowchart now. Without wasting much time, let us go to flowchart. Let us go to flowchart. Now, flowchart is a pictorial representation of an algorithm. So when you create an algorithm, so those algorithm steps will be taken and that is been converted to flowchart. Flowchart plays an important role in the programming of a problem and helping in understanding logic of program. Flowchart will help you in logics, okay? Once the flowchart is drawn, It becomes easy to write program in any high level language. Means what? For example, you take one question and the question will be converted into flowchart in a stepwise manner so that it looks pictorial or graphical representation of the algorithm. Once you break all those steps, then it is easy for you to create a program for that particular question in any language. In any language, you can create the program. Okay, it might be C program, C++, Java, Oracle, DBMS, SQL. There are n number of program language. I think Norbo is aware of ICC Java. One thing I want to share in this context, that is PUC board has a syllabus of computer science, and in this computer science your syllabus is on C++, whereas in ICSE it is Java. Java is more advanced than C++. So those who have learned Java in school, they can easily understand C++. That is for sure, 100% I assure you. Norbu should not find difficulty in C++, because the way of writing is different. That's it. But the concept, the content, okay, everything is same. For example, I'll tell you, Norbu, in Java, to print a statement, what syntax you use? Please answer to me. To print a statement, Norbu. Yes, to print a statement, what we use? To print a statement, we use system.out.println. Okay, system.out.println in the flower bracket or in the bracket with the double quotes, we will write something that will be the statement of the syntax. Whereas in C++, it will be C in, C out. Okay, in C program, it is scanf. Okay, let us come back to the flowchart now. Flowchart are classified into two categories. The first one is program flowchart. The second one is system flowchart. Now, let us understand what is program flowchart. Program flowchart present a diagrammatic representation of a sequence of instruction or for solving a problem. See, program flowchart is nothing but it is programmed. For example, you have annual day, all those things, okay? So before we start the annual day, we will prepare a flowchart. We will prepare a flowchart like this, okay? What is it? For example, I'm just keeping a paper. Agenda. First one is the lighting the lamp, then price distribution, then chief guest addressing, then cultural event, then vote of thanks. See, there is a way, there is a proper way, there is a sequence. Okay, there is sequence of instruction given in the paper that this will start first, followed by this. And next is this, after that this, and end with this. Okay, end with this. Means what? Program flowchart is nothing but the sequence of instruction given using pictorial representation. Got it? Prabhanjan, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Norbo, understood? What is program flowchart? Unmute yourself, Norbo.
Sir, can you please repeat from the last part?
Louder, louder, what?
Can you please repeat from the last part?
Okay, program flowchart.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'll start with the flowchart only. See, flowchart is very, very useful in each and everybody's life. See, it is like a timetable. First period, I will do this. 10 o'clock, I'll do this. 10:30, I'll do that. 11:30, I'll do this. 1 o'clock, I'll have my lunch. 1:30, I'll have a nap. Nap in a sense is small sleep. Okay. Then again, I'll get up and I'll freshen up and I'll go for a walk. And then I'll come and have some books, study for some time, and then have my dinner and go to bed. See, this is a sequence. Okay, this is a sequence of instruction giving to yourself. The command is giving to yourself that this is what you do first. Second, that followed by this. See here, there is a flowchart for your timetable. Okay. It's not that morning 8 o'clock you'll have dinner. Okay. Afternoon 1 o'clock you'll have breakfast. That mismatch is not a sequence of instruction. Sequence of instruction is to follow the order properly to solve particular problem. Okay. That is about sequence of instruction or program flow control. Second one is system flow chart. System flow chart includes the flow of data throughout the data processing system, as well as flow into and in and out of the system. Such flow chart are widely used by designers to explain data processing system. Means what? See, in and out of the system, the flow chart will give you direction. There will be a line mark or the arrow mark will be showing the flow is passing from this side, and the flow is passing from this angle to this angle, from there coming down and taking right, left, down, again up, left. Means what? System will follow the flow chart by using the arrow marks. System will follow the flow chart, but this system flow chart, most of the time, that is the internal part of the computer, whereas program flow chart is the person, the user, the person who is using the computer, the person who is using the computer will be the flow chart. Okay. Now, Anish, are you there?
Sir.
Yeah. Okay. Prabhanjan is there, and fine. So, before enter into flowchart, see, these are all theory part you need to understand carefully. But once we finish the theory part, rest all will be falling on the program only. So program will be there. We will be using the compiler. We will be typing the program. We will be understanding the question. We will break the question into steps. And by steps, we will create a flowchart. Through the flowchart, we will type the program, and then you will get the output. This is my agenda. This is my intention. Got it? I'll repeat one more time. The flow chart, the programs, the basic fundamentals, if you understand, nobody can stop you. Okay? It is like a play. It is like a play. See, if you don't understand and go further, then you will be ending up in a mess. Because programming cannot be by-hearted, my dear students. Don't by-heart the program, okay? Understand the program, understand the concept, okay? Understand the syntax, understand the errors, and debug the errors and get the output, okay? So you all will be there with me, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Others? Girls are, yes, not sir, talking at all. Come on, answer. Are you there with me, everybody?
Yes,
yeah.
Sir.
Okay, fine. Now, let us move forward to the next topic, that is importance of flowchart. Anish, can you see my screen? What is there on the screen?
Yes, sir.
What is there on the screen?
Yes, sir.
What is there on the screen?
Importance of flowchart.
Okay, fine. Then you are able to see.
Yes, sir.
So there are 6 important steps to follow the flowchart. Norbo, enable your video. There are six steps to follow the fourth flowchart. They are communication,
effective analysis.
Yeah, proper documentation, efficient coding, proper debugging, efficient program maintenance. Now let us discuss one by one. So communication, flowchart are better way of communicating of a logic of a program. Flowchart will communicate better because, so each one we are using the symbol. In flowchart, each concept we are using the symbol. In the algorithm, we started with start, then input, then definite process, then output, then stop. There were no symbols. So here, instead of wordings, we will use symbol. Inside that, we will be communicating with the logic of the program. Okay? The next one, effective analysis. With the help of the flowchart, problem can be analyzed in more effective way. Means what? If you have a flowchart, at a glance, you can see the problem. You can analyze the problem. You can find the solution in 100 ways. Yes or no? It's common to us also. You see a problem. Okay, you see a problem. For example, Prabhanjan is riding a bike. Okay? Okay, in the circle, one police jeep will be there. And unfortunately, Prabhanjan is not wearing his helmet and he has not brought his wallet. And without wallet, no deal. Okay? So what he will do? He saw the problem. Yes or no? He saw the problem which is standing little far away. Okay? Which is standing little far away. So he will think now. He will analyze. What is the best solution for this problem? Either I should just push him and just go, or either I should go back to my home, get my helmet and my wallet, okay? Or I should move from here, or I should stop my bike and go by walk and finish my walk and come back and take my bike. See here, for one problem, the problem was the jeep. But for one problem, I found 5 solutions. Okay? Because I analyzed the problem. This can be done. That can be done. If I do this, this police will not touch me. I can go in another way. See, there is something like that in the life also. Whenever you find or encounter any problem, take a long breath. Dear students, I'm not only a computer teacher, I just study students' eyes very well, okay? Whenever you find a mistake, whenever you are not feeling good, take a long breath and sense yourself. It's not like yoga. Take a long breath and sense yourself. As this is afternoon and you all had your lunch properly, I think you all had a heavy lunch, I feel, because no body shake is there. See, I am just moving around my neck, everything, and I am so energetic. But Prabhanjan, Norbu, Anish and all, no, they are just still. And that girl, she is not enabling the video. I'm really sorry. Please enable your video. That's good. See, when I see people, I interact more. Okay? Be energetic. Okay? Let us go to the next question, that is proper documentation. Now I gave a question and I told the solution also. We'll just bring it to the programming also. Proper documentation. Program flowchart serves as a good program documentation, which is needed for various program. Means what? The program documentation is nothing but the way of writing the program. You cannot write the program, hey idiot, do this. Hey idiot, do that. You cannot tell to the computer, or you cannot type the syntax like that. For each and every line, there is a proper way of writing. They are called as keywords, literals, okay, operators, all those things are there. All those things are there. Okay, so the proper way of writing the program is very, very important. Now, next one is efficient coding. So what is efficient coding? So the flowchart acts as a guide or a blueprint during the system analysis and program development. Means what? Efficient coding means if your communication is proper, if your analysis is proper, and the program what you have written is proper, then you can do your efficient coding and you can debug the program and you can get the output. Okay, so the above 3 points, if you are able to manage properly program documentation, if you write the program properly, if you analyze the problem and write according to the situation, and then you can code the program properly, then there will be easy for you to take out the error. Once you take out the error, then the final one is the output. Or when the output comes, you'll have a smile in your face. Let me share one example of mine. Okay, all are attentive, right? I'll share one example which I have fought, I have faced in my life. I was doing my master degree, okay? And in the third semester, there was a practical exam. Third semester, everybody listen, Prabhanjan, Anish, Norbo and all. Third semester, there was a practical exam. And I have tried my best to learn the program, okay? And I went. There, they have kept an answer paper like this. Okay? Answer paper in the sense, not answer paper, answer script. Answer, we need to fill, right, Prabhanjan? Yes. Yes, answer sir. We need to fill. But in between, there will be a small slip which carries the question. The question was very easy. Okay? The question was very easy. The question was, find the area of the rectangle, not rectangle, something like that. Okay, very simple program I got. As soon as I saw the question, I was happy, I was smiling. Ah, Chima, what is this here? I can do it. Within 5 minutes, I'll finish this program and I'll go out. And the duration was 1 hour. Okay, and they gave us only one check and it was only one question. And few programs were very difficult, and to keep it in mind, it was difficult. But fortunately, I got a simple program. Okay, and I took the answer paper and started writing. After started writing, you know, I don't think so you are aware of that. The examiner will give you empty paper. Okay, you will write the program there. Okay, and you cannot directly start typing the program in the computer. What you need to do? Prabhanjan, what you need to do after writing the program?
So we should save in desktop and open in a browser.
No, I have written it in a paper, no. Next step is what?
Execute.
No, Anish, I am in the exam hall, I have got answer script. And I finished my writing program. Next step is what?
We should fill in the computer, sir.
No, wrong. Norbo? Ashish?
Sir, you should write your index number.
Wrong. Let me see.
Check it once.
Check it once, yeah. I checked 10 times. Now what next?
Give it to the teacher.
Submit. Yes, exactly, Norbo. You have to give this answer paper to the examiner. Okay? Examiner will see and analyze the program and he will tell See, Manjunath, in the third line there is an error. If you could please make it properly, you will get the output. Otherwise, you won't get the output. And seventh line, 12th line, 13th line, you have done mistake. It might be a small mistake, but you cannot run the program and get the output. Can you try once and he'll give the answer paper back? Again, you sit. Okay. Again, you sit and you do all those trying everything you do, but somehow you'll write and again you'll go to exam and show. So I finished. Can I start typing the program and execute? Then what happens? The examiner will sign here, evaluated and can proceed for execution. If that is not written, you cannot touch the computer also, because you might bring it in pen drive, you might bring it in other source or something like that. Okay, this is the rules of the practical examination. In the coming days in PUC, you will also face the same kind. Okay, then I got the answer. I went to computer. Best part, you believe me, I finished typing and I compiled the program. When I compiled the program, I got only one error. Okay, I got only one error and it was around 15 minutes over. Now still 45 minutes were there. And I was so naughty in those days. I'll tell you, like you people, you all are young. In my young age, I was so naughty. I want to run out of English and I have to make hippe pure, all those things. I got one error. Imagine at what time I came out. Can anybody guess?
Last 5 minutes, sir.
Last 5 minutes. If I don't get the output, the examiner will definitely not pass, because output is the passing mark. If I don't get the output, he will not pass me. Okay? Till the last second, I was seated in front of the computer, blinking eyes each and everybody and asking, please see what is the error. Can you please solve? I was asking the help that day. But nobody helped us, because nobody will help in the examination hall. And still I was seated, I was trying. Examiner came to me, Manjuna, see, I can see the mistake. See there, that, this, see, I cannot tell you everything. Just see the, I can see the error, you are not able to see. You are in a hurry to go out. Come on, Manjuna, he said. Till the end, everybody finished and the bell rang. I was really disappointed, okay? And then the examiner came to me and said, Manjunath, seventh line semicolon is missing. Put the semicolon and run the program. I put the semicolon, zero error, and I got the output. See, a small change can make your life better. I checked each and every line, but end of the line, full stop and semicolon, hyphen, colon, I didn't observe. I was just looking in the beginning of the line and I was having confidence. Oh, everything is fine. See, a small one semicolon made me to sit for 45 minutes and I didn't get the output, but still that external was good. He passed me. Okay, he was good to me and he know me very well. So he passed me and he said, be attentive in the class. Be attentive in the class and don't think that you are so much smart. Better than you, there are 100 in the market. Okay? Got it. I just wanted to share, because if you don't write the program properly, if you don't have your patience to write the program, or if you don't want to write the program, or the current proper documentation is not there in the program, then you cannot debug the program, you cannot run the program. So these are the flowcharts, and I shared my experience also. Let us go to the next one. As I said, we are using the symbols, correct? So symbols are like this. So the oval shape, okay, symbol, terminal start and stop, okay? Whenever you start typing the program, this symbol should be written in the beginning and in the end. Beginning should be the same symbol and end should be the same symbol. Beginning should be start and end should be stop. You have to write inside that. Whatever the commands you are writing, that should be written inside the computer. Second one, input or output. So input or output, whatever you're using, you should be using that symbol. And the third one is processing. So processing will be the rectangular, big rectangular, then preparation, and this diamond symbol, it's about decision or branching, predefined process, connectors, and flow direction. So by using all those things, we are writing the program, we are writing the flow chart. Got it? We are writing the flow chart. Now, I believe that everybody are having your textbook with you. Everybody having the textbook with you?
No, sir.
Okay, now I will tell you, open page number 104.
No, sir. I don't have, sir.
You don't have? Why, you didn't collect the textbooks?
Too scared to come there, sir.
Okay. Just listen carefully then. Okay, in the example 5.1, Pranjan, you read the question. The question 5.1.
Sir, half of the page is not there, sir.
Toned,
huh? Yes, sir.
Okay, anybody else? Anish? Ashish?
Flowchart to interchange the value of two variables.
Yeah. Flowchart to interchange the value of two variables. Now, you should know what is variable. How many of you know what is variable? Just give me a thumbs up. Just give me a thumbs up. If you know what is variable.
So variable, alphabet, sir.
It's alphabet. Why do we use alphabet? Come on, why do we use alphabets? Norbo, enable your video. Norbo is so smart. When I turn my eyes to Pranjan or Ashish or Anish, I'm sorry to ask you, what's the name of this girl? Pink t-shirt?
Lipika, sir.
Huh?
Lipika.
Lipika, oh my God, I always get confused. Lipika, Lipika, Lipika. I'll keep it in mind. Okay. Okay. Variable is nothing but it is the alphabet. It is used to store a value. So in program, what happens? You want to store a value, you need a particular memory location. Norbo?
Yes, sir.
How many types of data types are there? Norbo, how many types of data types are there?
Seven.
Name them. Come on. Forgot everything, Norbo? You are computer students now in school?
Yes, sir.
Okay, dear students, I'll tell you now. This is very important to know what is variable. There are two types of variable, not seven. Norbu, the answer was wrong, but indirectly it was correct also. Okay, indirectly it was correct, but it is wrong. There are two types of data types available. They are composite data type and primitive data type. Okay, so all data type is used to store the value of a variable. Now, data type, see, a primitive data type, there are 8 primitive data types. How many are there? Anish, how many are there?
8, sir.
Yes, 8 data types are there, and all 8 data types can store the value of different range. Keep it in mind. Different range in the sense, I'll tell you the 8 data types. Int, float, double, char, like that there are 8 data types. Now here, int can store less number, for example 5 number. Double can store 10 number. Float can store decimal number. Int cannot store decimal number. Float cannot store whole number. Keep it in mind. Float, the float data type is also called as real time data type or real number data type. This is about primitive data type. When it comes to composite data type, there are two types. One is array and other one is interface. See, array and interface, you can create your own data type and store your values. Got it? So this is one. Now the question was, flowchart interchange the value of two variable. Now the symbol I told you, beginning symbol is, what is the symbol? What is that symbol? Can you tell me? It looks like oval.
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
yes,
it looks like oval. So the starting and the end should be in oval. And input or output. See in the program, start is the start. Then input A comma B. So two variables means you are going to use two alphabets. Okay. Two alphabets you will be using. And then interchange the value of two variables. This is very interesting. I'll tell you, this program is very interesting because see here, for example, A is equal to, I'll just take the slide one more. Wait. Okay. Now, for example, A is equal to 10. A is equal to 10 and B is equal to 20. Interchange the value. Now flowchart says interchange the value. Now I started. See everybody, see the screen carefully. Start int A comma B. A I gave a value 10, B I gave a value 20. But output should be what? It should be A should be 20 and B should be 10.
Yes,
somebody spoke. Please speak.
A should be 20, B should be 10.
A should be 20 and B should be 10. Okay. To do that, we will use a dummy variable. Okay. Now, A is a variable and 10 is the value. B is a variable and 20 is the value. And yes, third time, we are using temp. Temp is nothing but a temporary variable, or in programming language, we call it as dummy variable. This temp will have nothing and there is no capacity, no respect to that temp. But without that temp, we cannot interchange the value. It is a dummy variable. By using that, we will interchange. Now how? Temp is equal to A. Now A is what? Prabhanjan, A is what?
10.
Between temp and A, what is there?
Assignment.
Assignment operator. Ashish, what does assignment operator do? Ashish Sharif, what does assignment operator do? Norbo, don't Google there. Temp is equal to A. See here, the symbol is, when you're using is equal to symbol, right hand side and the left hand side should be equal. Now temp is separate and A is separate, correct? But the situation is not like that. We're interchanging the value. So temp is equal to A. So A is equal to temp, no? temp is equal to A and A is equal to temp. So
yes, sir.
A is temp and temp is A. Okay. Next line again. So temp value became what?
10.
A. 10.
Temp value will become 10.
10.
Now A is equal to B. Now B value is what?
20.
A value is what?
10.
10, correct. Now A value was 10 and B value was 20. So here right hand side should be taken carefully. So B is equal to A is equal to B. So B value is 20, A is also 20 now. Okay, next again. B is equal to temp. B is equal to temp. Now what happened? Tell me.
10 is equal to 20.
It is equal to B. Now what happens? Tell me.
A is equal to B, sir.
A is equal to B. Now, in the beginning, what was A?
Temp.
Now, after that, in the middle part, what will happen? A become B. 20 and B become 10. So, this is how the interchange will happen. This is how swapping will happen. Okay, this is how swapping will happen. See here, A's value will become come to B's value, and B's value will come to A's value. A's value will go to temp. So by using this swapping, the temporary variable will interchange, and then output is equal to A comma B, and then stop the flowchart. Understood this mechanism?
Yes, sir.
This mechanism, we use this in so many other matters, so many other programs, so many other situations. Got it? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. So, see, example 5.2. Flowchart to find the area and circumference of the circle. The question is clear. So, start. Again, input, area and circumference is what? Radius, right? Now, input radius, area for area, what is that formula is? What is area formula? Prabhanjan?
Pi r square.
Litika, what is area formula? Unmute yourself. Area formula.
Pi r square.
Pi r square.
Yeah. And circumference formula?
2 pi r.
2 pi r.
So you should know the formula according to that. Now radius is r into r. So if you do this and type the output, area and circumference, the flow chart is completed. Is it so simple or difficult? Understood? Start with start and then input R, that is radius, and find the area and circumference of the circle. Circles, radius, I am going to find out. So area is pi r square and circumference is 2 pi r. So by using r, wherever you put r, the whatever the value you input in that r, that has to be multiplied by 3.142, that is 22/7. Okay, then finally you should get the output, that is output area comma circumference. So here you should keep it in mind, input and output, that is parallelogram symbol. So the first one, start, beginning or end is oval symbol, and process or calculation or assignment is rectangle, decision or branching is rhombus. Then rest all will encounter when we go to such situation. Now we have come to this part, slowly we'll move further. I think it's time now, and I was really happy that everybody's face I was able to see, and you were attentive, and I appreciate that. I acknowledge these kind of students who show their interest in their studies. Though you are in house and we are in different places, the cooperation is highly appreciated. And Norbu?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Thank you so much for being patient and understanding. Now, any doubts or anything, you can contact me. So I will type my number here. Okay, I want you to create. I want somebody to take this charge. Who will take this charge? Create a group of first QC science. First QC. Who will take the responsibility of this group? Prabhanjan, can I assign you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, create a group of computer science of PU first. Give a name and search a proper icon for that image and add everybody. Okay. Yes, see if you understand the concept, any doubts you can then and there clarify. Need not have to wait for 1 week. That's why I'm doing this. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you so much. Bye for now. We'll Bye, meet sir. You in the next week, and most probably our computer science class will be this day, this week only. Means every week, Wednesday, 3 to 3:50, I am trying to freeze it because I have to take other class also. ICIC classes are also there for me. So 3 to 3:50 will be freezed. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Ritika, is it fine?
Sir.
Yeah. One more girl was there. I'm not able to see. She left, huh?
She left, sir.
What's your name?
Subiksha.
Okay. Okay, then thank you so much. See you in the next week. Bye bye. I'm ending the class now.
Bye, sir.
Bye.
Bye. Sir. Bye. Sir, your number?
It is on the screen. You didn't see?
No, sir. It's not this.
810 5657 178.
Sir, 1 second, sir. 810
5657
5657
178.
Okay, sir.
Okay, I'm ending the session now. Okay, thank you so much. Sir. We'll meet you in the next class. Bye.
Bye, sir.
Bye, sir.